Hi, I'm David the Bruce, and today we have a real interesting film for you on the Jungle Queens. This one is called The Jungle Princess from 1920, obviously a silent film, and it stars Juanita Hansen. Interesting gal. I'll talk to you about her in just a moment, but I do want to say that this is considered by some to be the very first Jungle Queen movie. And it was the first to use actual wild animals in a movie. Not stock footage, but actual footage. Pretty close to where they were filming this in California, there was a zoo, and they just brought in real animals. So what you see in this film is the real McCoy, not stock footage. This film is really a cut-down version of another film called The Lost City, which is said to be the very first Lost City movie. There's been many Lost City movies, as you probably know. And that one was a 15-episode serial that showed in theaters, you know, one episode a week. And it is said to be in the vault of Warner Brothers, and they haven't released it on DVD or any other way. Too bad, because we don't have any copies. It's maybe the reason they haven't is because haven't released it is because it is in the public domain, and if they released it, anybody could just copy it and use it, and you know, it would cut their profit. So I don't know, but I just think from a historical point of view, they should release it. So The Lost City was 15 episodes, and they cut it down to 52 minutes and re-released it as The Jungle Princess, and they did it all in 1920. Can you imagine that? So they made this the feature version of the serial. And now I'd like to tell you just a little bit about Juanita Jensen. She was born in Iowa in 1895, yep. And she made her way to Los Angeles, graduated from Los Angeles High School, and then found employment with the author of The Wizard of Oz. Yeah, Frank Borzage. He had a motion picture company. I don't know if you knew that or not. And he made Oz films. Yes, he did. And so that was in 1914, and she was age 17. Her career would last only 14 years, and she retired. What did her in largely in her career, which was pretty successful, the films that she made, people really loved her, and they came. She was a box office attraction, very beautiful gal. Cocaine and morphine was her poison of choice, and she became extremely addicted, and it just really interrupted her life. So she retired from film in 1928, and she wasn't really drug-free until 1934. She went through quite an ordeal. She wrote a book about it, hoping to help others not to get into the kind of situation that she found herself in, or to help people come out. She also toured prisons and stuff like that. She became a regular campaigner to get people off drugs and established a charity for the same reasons. Amazing gal, just incredible and beautiful. What do you see her in this? And she really does sizzle when she's acting. People say maybe she overacts, you know. She has this frizzy hair and these big eyes. It's really wild. So, I don't know, maybe she was on cocaine or heroin at the time. I'm not sure. That's not a nice thing to say. But yeah, she's pretty wild in this. So you're going to enjoy this film. I wish I had a better copy of it to show you, but oh, this one's good enough. It's good enough. You'll get it. Without any further ado, I'm David the Bruce. So let's go.
Thank you. Thank you.